Dave Ritzko from Transtar. I'm the technical product specialist. And today's more or less is about a little tech tip or a trick in how to find a leak in a hard detected area. Now, a little history on this from me is a long time ago I was working on a 727, and the younger generation probably won't know it, but the old schoolers, we cut our teeth on it. And I had a leak in one. And I pulled it in and out several times before one of the old timers shared a tip with me that I'm going to share with you today. And on the 727, it actually happened to be a little screw at the bottom that holds in the servo lever arm that was loose and trickling out. Had it not been for the tip, I'd have been stuck pulling it out more. What was his tip? Baby powder. Well, I looked at him funny too. So, say a vehicle with this type of bell housing runs in. You cannot see up there with a flashlight. May not be able to get a camera thing back in there. And again, kind of hard to do when it's running anyway. After it leaks all over, everything's wet. How do you tell where the leak is? Could it be coming from the front seal? Could it be coming from the O-ring around it? Could it be coming from one of the numerous bolt holes? Could it be a bad casting? Front leaks are super hard to find. So, you get yourself some baby powder. Again, it's kind of cheap. This is just an off-brand. You can buy the big jugs, you know, wherever you want to go. And what you would do with this, you try to clean as much as possible out of it. In other words, get it out. You really don't want standing fluid, so you take brake clean, whatever, blow it dry. Then you would take this powder and you would put a handful in. And again, baby powder is very similar to drywall dust. When you blow it around, it gets everywhere and sticks to everything. You'll find it on everything. So on a bell housing like this, if you have a little shield you could get in, maybe you have to take the starter out and go through the starter hole. Wherever you do, you take it and you hold your hand real close and you take a blowgun and you blow the powder off. And again, it's messy, but so is the leak you have. So is pulling it out many times. So again, what you're doing is applying a coat of powder around this bell housing. Now, when you run that and it starts to leak, you will see a clean trail, whether it's coming from here, from a bolt hole. If you see a wet, damp area somewhere around the webbing or the casting, it's a bad casting. So after I mentioned this to someone before, a fellow replied, and he has maybe a better way of doing it. You clean the bell housing and stuff. Then you get you a container, whether it's a pop can, a coffee can, whatever kind of container you use, and use solvent, alcohol, brake clean, something that dries pretty quick. You take your baby powder, you mix it in there, shake it up real good, and kind of what you created is a baby powder paint. Then I would use a blowgun like this, dip it in the can, because this will siphon it up on the way. Some people have the spray cans that you could put air in and blow it around. I think this is a good idea here. You stick it in the can of the baby powder paint. You get up into anywhere you can get up into, and you kind of move it around. And basically what you're doing is painting the inside of this. Let it dry a little bit till it sticks. Again, follow the same procedure, start it up, let it run, drive it however long it takes for the leak to come. And again, wherever the baby powder would leak from, whether it's the seal, the O-ring, a bolt, or whether it's the casting itself, you'll find a leak, and generally you'll find it the first time versus pulling it in and out and guessing. And again, guys, this is just a tip and a trick that I learned a long time ago that I would like to pass on to you. And again, if it can help you find a leak quicker versus pulling it in and out, you save a little time, a little coin in your pocket to find a leak right away. Thanks for watching. And as always, you can always look us up on transcend.us, transstar1.com, Or as always, contact your TranStar sales rep. Thank you for watching.